In this section about the lumbar role, we'll be looking how to help side bending. We have seen so clip to help generically the lumbar with an articulatory lumbar roll technique. We have seen rotatory lesions, and we have seen problems of flexion and extension. And we will go now into side bending. Quite simply, there are people that maybe they can side bend to the left, but they find it very difficult to move their lumbar area in order to side bend to the right. So let's say, so first let me tell you this. Now, if there is difficulty for them to side bend to the right, what is normally called, what this is called, is that the spine is side bend to the left, because the spine has a curve, a kink towards the left, and is somehow blocked, or it has got a somatic dysfunction, as some people say, in being side bent to the left, it cannot easily move to the right. So what we want to do is to help it and to side bend it to the right. Now, there are different techniques to do that. I'll show you one very much based on a lumbar roll-like, and then we'll also see some very nice articulations. So let's say that she cannot side bend to the right because she's side bend to the left. So I have put her on her right side. I'm going to stretch her body nice and straight as much as possible. And what I'm doing now, I'm going to place a small towel, roll it, and put it under her waist. That's it. Now, if you think anatomically what is happening, let's look at this spine. So we said that her spine is side bent to the left. Okay, remember that this is my left and this is my right. So the spine is side bent to the left and cannot side bend to the right. So it is side bent to the left, like this. When I lie her down on her right side in this way, when I'm putting a towel underneath here, I am this side bending and this side bending her to the left. Okay? So work it out, and you can see easily the logic and the effectiveness of this movement. So again, what I will do now, just put the one leg down in a neutral, straight position, the other one slide bended, till I feel that it is creating a lever going to the lumbars. I don't rotate the shoulder very much, just very, very little, because it's not a rotatory lesion. And just this much, that's all. And this time, I place my forearm to stabilize her shoulder. Just be careful. Of course, this is for demo. It's not for lay people then to suddenly go home and they start doing lumbar rolls. It's for demo. But even, you know, if you are a practitioner, always be careful when you go down on the shoulder. You could dislocate it if you, you know, if you are not sensitive. So you are mainly using the shoulder just to stabilize the upper part of the body. Only a very, very little traction towards the head. Then I'm creating a lever from there, going to the lumbar spine. I slightly push down with my forearm, the pelvis against the plinth, stretch towards the foot. And then with my hands, I monitor the joints between the lumbars. So push down and push towards the feet, and very, very, very slight torsion, but very slight. So the movement is a little bit like this, okay? This kind of movement. And what I'm doing is stretching the spine and this side bending it. Okay. And no need of doing crack pops or high velocity techniques, as they are properly called. It's just a very gentle articulation, but which again is operating on a lumbar roll principle.